Hey guys, how's it going? Well, Christmas is coming up and I wanted to show some sort of holiday spirit. No, this is just to keep warm. Ow. So I got this request to make a Christmas tree flicker and I spent hours and hours and finally, ta-da, there it is, the Christmas tree flicker. And this is how it flies. And it can be a Christmas tree finger puppet and a dragon tail claw. And if you fold 5 of them, you can have a whole handheld forest of dragon tail finger puppet Christmas tree claws. And when the forest is under attack, they turn into spears. And what else? It can be a nose picker.
And in addition to all of that, it can also just be used as a Christmas tree ornament. You can decorate it, you could give it as a gift, or you could fold a whole bunch of them and use them as party favors. Or you could fold it really big and it could be the Christmas tree topper, or it could be a necklace, or you could attach it to a thread and you can make a whole bunch of them and it can be a Christmas tree garland. And the Christmas trees can dance.
And what's cool about it is that they always end up facing in the correct direction. And I'll show you how to do that. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. Alright, so for this model I'm going to use a 6-inch square of commie. Now you could use a sheet of printer paper cut square, but then you'll end up with a white tree. Unless, of course, you color it. Alright, so let's begin white side up. And we're going to pretend to fold it in half, so align the bottom edge to the top edge, but don't make the fold. Just, when it aligns, make a crease mark right here. Like that. And unfold. And now fold the corner to the crease mark. And once again, don't fold it all the way across. Just make another crease mark right there. And unfold. And once again, fold the corner to this crease mark and make a third crease mark right there. And unfold. So we have 1, 2, 3 crease marks. Now we're going to make 3 crease marks on the opposite corner. So let's rotate it 180 degrees. Here's our 1, 2, 3 crease marks here, and let's make them here. So fold this corner to this corner and make your crease mark. And unfold and fold the corner to this crease mark. And unfold and fold the corner to this crease mark. Okay. And unfold. And I'm gonna just draw in that last crease mark and that last crease mark. Okay, we're gonna take those 2 last crease marks and bring them together. So fold it up so that they touch and make the fold. So it's like that. All right, now fold this edge onto this edge. So fold the flap up so that the 2 edges align. And crease it. And now turn over. And now we're going to fold between this point and this point. So fold the flap up, just the single flap. And make sure that it goes right to this corner and make the fold terminate here. Like this. And if you made your folds exact, just by chance, mathematically, these 2 edges should come together. All right, now rotate it. And now we're going to fold this flap up. We want to fold it so that the fold originates at this point and we want these 2 edges to align. So the fold is perpendicular to these edges. Like that. Oops, a little bit further. Okay. Yeah. And let's tuck this flap underneath the top layer and close it. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this flap up also on this point, and this time we align the edges and we tuck it underneath this front layer, like that. And crease it all sharply, Okay, this is gonna be the trunk of the tree. Let's zoom out. Now fold this flap over this edge. Try to make it hug tightly over the edge. That way you won't have much of a green line there. Okay, and turn over and fold this flap over this edge. And try to make it so that this is a clean point right up there. That's the top of the Christmas tree. All right, now rotate and fold this corner to this point where this edge touches this edge. So fold the corner to that point. Like that. And now fold this flap up so that the fold originates at the point right here. And we want this edge to touch this point where the two edges come together. And when it all aligns, then fold it across. And don't worry, it doesn't need to come to this corner. Okay, and now take this flap, unfold it, and tuck it into this pocket. Like that. Okay, now this is optional, but I'd recommend it for a better flying tree if you want it to be a flicker. What you do is you're gonna make a mountain fold that goes from here to here. So basically just take this edge and tuck it behind. Like that. That way you see we don't have this flap to pick up the wind. And now take this flap and tuck it into this pocket. So just tuck the corner into the pocket. And tuck it in as much as you can. It's not gonna go all the way in, but just about like that. I'm gonna show you from the other side. It looks like that. Okay. And now turn over, and we're going to repeat all that on this side. So fold the corner to this point. And fold this flap up so it goes to the corner and the edge goes to the intersection point. And unfold it and stick it into the pocket. And fold this flap behind. Like that. And fold this flap into the pocket. This pocket. Wrap it over the edge. Like that. And we are done, but upside down. There it is, the tree. And oh wait, one more thing to make the tree fly a little bit better is fold this edge up. I'm gonna just zoom in so you see what I'm doing. Fold this edge up a little bit. And we want this flap to have the same thickness. So this edge and this edge should be parallel. Like that. And turn over and do it again on this side. And crease those really sharply. Okay, and now go along it and just crease everything really super sharply. In order to see how aerodynamic it is, if you look at the edge, you want it to be pretty much a line. A line. And perhaps to make it fly a little bit better, you could give a little bit of curvature on the edges. That'll perhaps give it some lift and make it fly further. Okay, let's see how this thing flies.
All right, so to flick this thing, I'm gonna just hold it lightly at the trunk and hold it in this position and just flick it on this edge. I'm gonna try to go right in the middle of the edge, because if you go on the tip, it's not gonna fly very far. Here it goes. Ooh yeah, hit the light. Hit the light. When you flick it, make sure that you flick it straight, not up or down, just straight. And you can angle it a little bit. Here it goes. Oh yeah. Let's see if I can get it to the wall. Well, I got it to the left wall. Okay, try to get it to the back wall. That's what I'm trying to. Okay, I better tilt it a little bit more in this direction. Here it goes. Nope. It almost boomeranged. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Almost.
All right, so hopefully by now you've tried it out as a flicker, and I'm now going to show you how to make it into a dragon tail finger puppet Christmas tree claw. So what you wanna do is turn it over and unfold this little flap here and open up that flap. So you have this pocket right here. Now, if you stick your finger in it like this, it's not really gonna go on very easily. So what I recommend is taking a pencil or some other pointy object and poking it as far in as you can comfortably do, like that. So it opens up the pocket like that. And now, when you stick in your finger, it really hugs the finger and it'll stay on your finger like that. And like this, it's kind of like a tree on a hill. Here's the hillside and the tree is growing like that. But if you want it to be a little bit more like a traditional Christmas tree, then you can just tuck this flap inside like this. And there is the tree, like that. And while you're at it, you can fold a whole bunch of them and you can have a whole forest of dragon tail finger puppet Christmas tree claws. I think environmentalists and forestry people will like this model. And there you have it. Wah! Okay, now I'm gonna show you how to make the model stand. So what you wanna do is open up the tree again. And the important thing, well, it might even just stand like this, but what you want to do to make it stand is turn it over and make a fold that goes right on the middle like this. So it becomes on the bottom kind of three sides of a square, one, two, three, and it'll just kind of stand right on that. And you might have to adjust the folds down here to make it stand well. Like that. And it'll stand like this, and like that. So this is a tree rocking back and forth in the wind. Timber! Okay, now to make it a little bit more three-dimensionalized, what you can do, this is tricky, so only do this if you are up to the challenge. What you do is you stick your finger into this pocket and just open this up a little bit. You can kind of create a soft mountain fold, right? From the corner of the tree to here, and turn over and open it up here as well. And when you do this, try to make sure that the flap doesn't come out like that. No, we don't want that. We want the flap to stay in. So that's what it looks like. And just kind of sculpt it as much as you can to taste. So it's like that. And it's gonna be a little bit delicate, just trying to make sure that those flaps stay in there. That's perhaps the weakness of the model, but there it is. Blowing in the wind. Ooh, it also spins. So spin the Christmas tree. And it can be a rocket ship.
As I showed in the intro, another thing that you can do with this model is fold a bunch of them and attach them to a string. So you have a whole garland of Christmas trees and they rock. And I'm going to show you how to attach the trees to the thread so that they all stay facing the same way. So what you do is you take the tree, this is the one that I decorated, and you take the needle, thread the needle, and you want to insert the needle into this really thick layer inside. So open up this pocket, and on the back side, open up this pocket, and you want to stick the needle into that thick bunch of paper there. Make sure that you don't prick yourself. So just slide it through and make sure your fingers are out of the way and push it through. And like that. And this way, when you pull the thread, you see the model can't go either way. It's held so that it faces in front like this. All right, so there you have it. Hope you enjoyed folding this model. Whoosh. And hope you have a Merry Christmas or whatever other special day you celebrate. And I'll see you later. Bye bye. Whoosh. And this is how it flies. And this is how it flies. And try to aim for the middle, because that way it'll go the farthest. Here goes. And try to hit the thing.